I'm gonna tell you the Christmas message, special message. Now, today, oh, Merry Christmas, Hallelujah. I wanna tell the Mary, who the mother of Jesus Christ, whom Roman Catholic believe as a God. Huh? Mary. I wanna tell you Mary. Mary. I believe Roman Catholic is heresy. Mary, did you know that your baby boy whom you are the holding was born to become the savior of humankind? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our the son and daughters? This child that you would deliver will soon deliver you. You even didn't know that. Huh? And when you kissed your baby boy, you were kissed the face of the God. Oh. You were kissed the God's face. Huh? Mary, did you know that your baby would the give sight to the blind and the deaf will hear, and the lame will leap, and dumb will speak, the dead will rise again? You didn't know that. Mary, did you know that you have to watch your son die on the cross for the salvation of the humankind? Mary, did you know that you to see your son raised from the dead on Easter morning? Did you, Mary, listen, Mary. Did you know that your son would ascend to heaven and sit at the right hand of God? Think about that. All people who believe the Mary, who mother of Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the Roman Catholic. Okay, I got preaching. My sermon for my friend. When we receive the Holy Spirit, the God gives us the power, holy power, divine power. We got by the Holy Spirit, and we will be witness of Jesus Christ. You are the witness of Jesus Christ. I am all Christian. Witness of Jesus Christ. We have to testify. This evidence, what we have seen, that Jesus Christ, Son of God, this gospel, we have to speak this gospel because we are witness of Jesus Christ. The Greek word for witness is martus, which is also another meaning of martyr. Martyr. This means that after we receive the Holy Spirit with power, we need to be witness of the gospel and be willing to sacrifice our lives for the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We have to live. We have to live and willing to sacrifice. We have to do for the kingdom of the God. The life, new life you got. Our witness is the life that cannot help stopping from preaching the gospel. Even though troubles, the problem, lot of problem you have, and hardship come upon us, we have to preach this gospel as a witness of Jesus Christ. We gotta do, have to preach this gospel to the people who are sustained hungry in this world. Many disciples and servants of the Lord were martyred, you know, for preaching the gospel of Jesus. I want to tell you. In the martyred in Bible. Peter, the disciple, was crucified upside down. You know, Paul, the apostle, was beheaded under the reign of the Emperor Nero in Roman times. Mark, one of the 12 disciples, martyred in Alexandria. Philip was martyred in Asia Minor on the cross. Bartholomew was skinned, oh, I can't believe that, and died in utmost pain. That human kind couldn't endure in this pain. Thomas was martyred in the India. Let me tell you, that was India. God greatly blessed India now. This country is going up and develop and going to rich countries. You know, everybody know that. World is watching. This is India, especially technology realm, will be tremendously going up. Because Thomas was martyred in India. God remembered this event that India had happened. All right. Matthew was martyred being wounded by spear. Matthias, one of the 12 later, one of the disciples, was stoned and beheaded in Jerusalem. Like Isaiah did. Andrew, The brother of the Peter was martyred by the crucifixion in Edessa. Luke was martyred by the hanging on the olive tree in Crete. The history of the early church is the history of martyrdom. Thousands of the people were martyred because this gospel of Jesus. Due to this blood of the martyrdom, innumerable people could come to Jesus. Uncountable people would be saved by the blood of those people who died for the Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the martyr, witness of Jesus Christ. You are the witness of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, you are blessed. You are greatly blessed. Oh, can I tell you more? I'm going to tell you the history of our country. In 1907, the great revival of Korea broke out in Pyongyang. The great revival started at the Buhung Station in North Korea. Pyongyang is the capital city in North Korea now. The place, the Pyongyang, where missionary Thomas was martyred. Let me tell you the story of the Thomas who came from the America, the preaching the gospel to Joseon, which is Korea now, North Korea. All right, that is a great story. You can listen, my brother, sister. Watch this. Missionary Thomas was the first martyred missionary in Korean Christianity. He came to Joseon, which is Korea now, in 1863, when the ship reached the upper stream of the water of the river, Joseon soldiers set fire on them, and the ship was flame in the fire. So the people on board jumped up into the water. Thomas was jumped also into the water. Listen, Thomas gave the Bible. He gave the Bible a Joseon soldier named Chun Gwon Pak, who was about to slash Thomas with the saying, God loves you. Thomas said, Joseon soldier who going to kill him, he said, God loves you. Listen, I didn't finish it. What happened? Park, Chun Gwon Park, brought home the Bible given by missionary Thomas, who he beheaded While he was reading the Bible, the Holy Spirit touched him. And his heart stirred up. And at last he became Christian. Later, he became the great figure in the church history of Korea, my country. Due to the blood of the martyrdom of missionary Thomas, Pyongyang was later called the Jerusalem of Orient. Yes, we call the Pyongyang, that is Jerusalem of Orient. Another Jerusalem located in Korea. Oh, hallelujah. And there are more than 12 million Christians in my country now. Since the people of North Korea are under the power of communists, they cannot freely believe in Jesus Christ. That's very sad now. However, listen, I believe all Christians believe in South Korea. We believe, we praying now to our country for unification of our country. One day, God will unify. God will take out this evil empire in North Korea. And the gospel will be preached in North Korea soon. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Huh? Oh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, thank you. Giving glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, my. Yeah, I strongly believe North Korea will be unified and the gospel of Jesus will be preached that area to those people who don't know the truth and Jesus Christ. Good news. Region. God called us. God called you. Is to make us to be witness of the gospel of Jesus to the end of this earth. Bible say, this gospel of kingdom will be preached to the end of the world. Then the end of this world will be end. Luke 24, chapter 48. You are witness of these things. What is these things? Christ's message of God's love. You have experienced. You have tasted God's love. I know God's love, God's truth, truth of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the truth. And the forgiveness of our sin. You are forgiven by the blood of Jesus Christ. Huh? I say again, this God's message. This I'm talking about what Jesus Christ said according to the Bible. Jesus said to disciples before he go to heaven, as a commandment, you should keep. What is that? This is the bottom line of Jesus Christ, what he said. I say again, listen carefully. Christ's message, core message of God's love. That is God's love. And the forgiveness of sins should to go to all the world. We must never ignore the worldwide scope of Christ's gospel. We shouldn't ignore. We always keep on this gospel. God wants all the world to hear the good news of salvation. Greatest thing is not healing. Greatest thing is not some gift of God. Greatest thing is the prophecy. No. Greatest thing is the salvation of souls. We have to preach for the winning souls. When we have to preach this gospel, which Jesus Christ commanded us. We have to live. We have to live. You have to live as a witness of the gospel, not witness of Jehovah. Sound is like heresy. You know what I'm talking about. Don't go there. Don't go witness of Jehovah. Jehovah witness. It's heresy. All right. And the Holy Spirit comes on us to make us into witness of the gospel. We have to fulfill. We have to fulfill the task as a witness. As a fulfilled servant of God, God will be pleased when you preach the gospel as a witness. God is going to bless you. Oh, my Lord. Oh, hallelujah. If we do not become witness for the gospel, even after receiving the Holy Spirit, we should live with a shameful salvation on this earth. I would say again, if you don't live as a witness of Jesus Christ, the salvation we have received is shameful. Nothing. Not useless. You understand what I'm saying? Shameful. Buried sin. All you and me must be the witness of the gospel. Preach the good news of the Jesus today. listen, good news, our station, motto is good news, Jesus preached all over the world. This is Korean letter, Mark 16, 15. You know, the Mark 16, 15, the commandment of the Jesus Christ. This is our motto in our in the good news internet network. When the gospel reaches out to the end of the earth, the road will come, as I said. Okay. Let me finish. Do you have a family member who are not Christian yet? I urge you to give the gospel to your relative, the family, by this year. You know, if anyone dies without knowing Jesus, he will fall down to eternal punishment, to hell. They go to hell. Hell. If, let me tell you something. If someone is drowning into the water, well, you know, what you can do there? We have to throw the, you know, the life vest and the rope and the tube to save to him. Right? Am I right? In the same way, many people are going to drowning into the water now. We have to throw the and the tube and the life jacket to save their souls. We must throw the tube of salvation, and the life vest. We have to throw to them to save the soul. Hallelujah. Before this year will be ended. Hallelujah. Amen. I pray that God will bless you abundantly. God will make a resolution to live and witness of the gospel. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You are the witness of Jesus Christ, that you should preach this gospel, even though you're something problem and hardship. God will ship out, and God gonna bless you. If you preaching this gospel, God will be with you. Holy Spirit will lead you wherever you preach. Gospel should preach to the end of the world, because you, God loves you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hallelujah. Pray to amen.